like we said in the last video, this is the one that someone has been waiting for. This is Here Comes the Squirrel Squad!
Awesome. We got so many jokes out of this episode, I was killing myself. So basically our friends are still on the way to Vermilion City.
Still?
Yep. And they fall down a big giant hole in the middle of nowhere for like the 90th time has to have been. Who would ever do such a thing? Look up, and there's a bunch of Squirtles all wearing sunglasses and kill themselves laughing. And the leader's got like these big spiky sunglasses and the other ones look like John Lennon. So it turns out the Squirtle Squad are a bunch of abandoned Squirtles who were like left behind by their trainers.
And they wreak havoc.
They just torment the town. They're a little gang of bastards and they don't do horrible things, but they like do graffiti and steal fruit and just...
generally cause havoc.
Cause havoc and chaos and be pests. Play tricks on people, that kind of thing. So this episode is obviously to introduce the third member of the original Pokemon trio, Squirtle. My favourite, because he's awesome. And very, very funny as well, which you get from this episode. So this is kind of, there's a lot of humour in this episode.
Yeah, this one is very funny.
It's a kind of a daft one, but it has a nice like ending and everything.
It's one I feel that it's a brilliant episode to riff over. You can sit there and just make hundreds of jokes.
Slightly racist jokes.
Yeah.
Like, what was the one about Jango? The S is silent.
Yeah.
Because they all just look like gang members.
Well, there's a bit where it's pretty much...
He's like...
Pikachu and Squirtle are pretty much going to have a Western face off. So I just kind of went... It's just silent.
What was the other one we're laughing at? Where they corner Team Rocket. It's like, you come to the wrong town, bitches.
Looks like Thumb was a little lost.
So that happens. They sort of capture Team Rocket and nick their picnic food. So Team Rocket trick, or Meowth tricks.
And they keep calling rice balls jelly donuts.
Yeah, that's weird. They don't... Anyway, I suppose they probably thought kids wouldn't know what a rice ball is.
Yeah,
it's a triangle of rice with a piece of seaweed on it.
In case you didn't know.
I think it's called onigiri. Or onigiri.
Someone out there's going to go, no!
No, it's O-N-I-G-I-R-I. Onigiri. Onigiri.
Yeah, there's still going to be someone going, no!
No!
You are wrong!
I probably am, but I don't give a shit.
Yeah.
So they're eating... The Squirtles have nicked Team Rocket's food and Meowth decides to trick them into being their friends and helping them catch Ash and Misty and Brock so they can get the Pikachu, of course. Which they do. Pikachu gets horribly injured by a rogue... What's the fish called? Goldeen.
He gets a spike to the ass.
He gets a spike to the ass. And Pikachu passes out. So while Misty, Brock and Ash are all tied up, Pikachu's about to die. Oh no. So they give him he gives him a couple of hours to go and get a super potion. And you can carry on.
They threaten to turn Misty's hair purple. Shocker.
Well, that'd be awesome. Who wouldn't want purple hair?
Ash gets to a western town.
Yeah, that was...
Anyway, so he gets a super potion, finds out Team Rocket are planning to throw bombs at the Squirtle Squad to get rid of them so they can obviously take the Pikachu and run scot-free. Ash gets the super potion, runs back, gives it to Pikachu, Team Rocket turn up, throw the bombs, and then Ash saves one of the Squirtles.
The one with the spiky, the leader.
Yeah, the leader. Saves the leader of the Squirtles. They join together, save Pikachu.
No, but he's stuck on his back like Bender in that episode. Yeah.
So he saves the Squirtle. Squirtle and Ash join together to save Pikachu. Team Rocket blast. James
is here!
Yes, he's actually arrived now.
And there was a Gary sighting.
Yes,
well.
There was
a 3-second Gary sighting.
It was literally Ash is about to go into the shopping at the Super Potion. Door hits him in the face.
Gary!
So Gary does that. Anyway, so back to the end of the episode.
James is here. James' voice is finally here.
Yeah, James has finally arrived.
Campus Christmas voice. I gotta love him.
Yeah, gotta love him. So Team Rocket blast off, but they didn't ding.
They didn't ding, yeah.
But we're nearly there. Once they ding, we're there. Yes. So, and then Squirtle joins the team.
Well,
with a big hug.
The Squirtle Squad become like the town firefighters, which is just adorable.
Because they're wearing little
They're
little
all like
coats.
Wearing little, I don't want to call them samurai coats. They're like,
Like sort of kimonos.
Like kimonos, but they've got a name. I can't remember. It's like my one that I've got.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They're like little, like, no, who gives a shit? They're wearing little kimonos that say they're the firefighters, and then Spiky Glasses Squirtle, the leader, decides to join Ash. And,
then he takes his glasses
and
off.
And he's got big, sparkly, lovely eyes. It's like, oh, I love him so much. He's adorable. I want my own Squirtle.
Do we need to ask what you thought of the episode?
I'll give my honest opinion is because, yeah, I love this episode because it introduces Squirtle, and Squirtle's the best. Better than all. He is, Squirtle's just lovely. He's funny as well. He tends to have most of the funny moments in later episodes, and he's just a little bit of a bastard. But it adds the third character.
Yep, so Ash has got all the starters now. Considering he came out of Pallet with a Pikachu which didn't listen to him, he's done pretty well.
That's why he's the hero.
Because he's managed to get all the starters now.
He's the Pokemon master.
Ah, yes.
It also has James' voice coming to play.
Yay.
It's a fun episode as well.
Yeah.
The jokes in there, there's plenty to be had. There's loads of times you can just sit there and imagine what the Squirtles are saying.
Yeah.
Bitch, please. You look like
my bike, bitch. Please, they join it? Rick Grimes.
Oh, no, it's not that. It's my bike. Okay, bye. Oh, no.
I can see Rick Grimes being in their group.
Yeah, you got ground.
You got ground.
I will say one thing. Why do they never name their Pokemon? You do the same.
No,
you
I
never
don't.
Name your Pokemon. I always give my Pokemon names.
There's plenty of people out there who give their Pokemon very dodgy names as well.
Yeah, but it makes it easier to decipher who's who. Like, if I had a Pikachu, I'd call it Lexi.
Okay.
If I had a Squirtle, I'd call it Buffalo.
Okay. I like this episode. I don't think I ever saw this episode when it was originally aired, because I really don't remember it. But this episode was a barrel of laughs to get. Pretty much every couple of minutes, you were just creasing yourself.
It's another
laughing.
One where the Pokemon has a personality as well, which is what I like, because you've got a lot of the Pokemon.
Bulbasaur's like sort of like the tough one.
He's a bit of a grumpy bastard.
Yeah.
Charmander's just lovely. And Squirtle's a little kind of a
little shit.
He's naughty and cheeky. And then Pikachu's
he's
kind
cheeky
of,
and fun with
Pikachu's
it.
Pikachu's kind of somewhere in between. I think Pikachu, I've always thought Pikachu's a girl, not because it's played by a girl. Yeah. But they call him it, don't they? They never say he or she.
Yeah.
Pikachu to me always seems like a girl.
Mm. Yeah.
Like a playful little girl or something. I think that's adorable.
Yeah. But yeah, I did really enjoy this episode. I thought it was really funny. I wouldn't be surprised if someone has put on like YouTube or something, like the episode and them riffing over it.
Loads of Squirtle.
Loads of stuff you could just do with this
Squirtle
episode.
Squirtle memes. It's all like, I'm gonna tap that ass.
While he's wearing the spiky glasses.
He's got his shit's going down.
There's loads of times you could put Samuel L. Jackson quotes over it as well. Does he look like a bitch?
Oh my god, awesome.
Yeah. So seriously, just give this episode a watch, because you could seriously have a bunch of laughs watching this episode.
And many more Squirtle episodes, please.
Yes.
Well, I think this is the point now, I hope.
Where we really...
kick off.
Hopefully the next episode they'll actually get to Vermilion City. Because they
know
still...
the name of the next episode is?
I haven't looked yet. So hopefully they'll actually get there. Or we'll have another 5 episodes of them not getting there.
Yeah, because he earned like 2 Pokemon badges in the first 10 episodes. And now it's taken him ages to earn his next one.
Yeah. Come on, Ash.
Can we go to bed now?
Get your game on. Yes, we can go to bed now. We'll see you next time.